by looking at more brand new Star Wars The Vintage Collection figures. We've got Yak Face or Saelt-Marae, Scarif Stormtrooper, Princess Leia as Boosh, and Klaatu the Skiff Guard. And we're going to go through all of them. We'll give you separate vids for each one. Picked up two cases at Darkside Toys, got them shipped. Excellent shipping, packed like an absolute baby. Shared a picture on Instagram, and as usual, just mint. Every one of them. Flawless, not one single thing. The way they packed it inside with the extra bubbles around, and then inside the other box, and then the big box. So kudos to them for it again. As usual, as always, packing really well. If you want to pick it up from them, link in the description below. So, 3.75 figures. Amazingly, there's still some people out there who kind of... Well, often we posted a lot of pictures and did a show there just after Toy Fair. And even though Matt and I were talking about some of the figures and saying this is 6-inch, and obviously it's the 6-inch show, people were still asking, is this 3.75? Is this 6-inch? So I'm not taking the piss out of you, but there's clearly a lot of people that are still really, really confused about the figures. And I guess it's hard to tell from the images. So Vintage Collection, TVC, is all 3.75 inches. All the other stuff... It's 6 inches, generally. If it's a 6-inch or black series figure, it's 6 inches. So, amazingly, there's people out there that don't know, but there you go. Yak Face, we're going to get a look at him, or, and I'm pronouncing it probably wrong, Saelt-Marae, I do not know. You tell us, leave a note in the comment and tell us what the pronunciation of this character correctly is. I guess I should ask Jason, shouldn't I? I'm doing a show with him at the weekend, I'll ask him, he'll know, hopefully. Considering that is the name of his site, well, Yak Face. Kenner is the logo, obviously, on all of the Vintage Collection. This card seems a little bit thicker to my mind. I don't know. Maybe not. Probably not. But it feels a little thicker. I don't know. Something about the quality of it seems a little better than some of the first wave of the Vintage Collection that we had with... Oh dear, some of the Rogue One figures, etc. So, really good looking figure. Gorgeous card art. This is the first time we've had this figure since, what was it, 1987, Power of the Force 2, in 1985 it kind of got released, re-released around that time. I don't know, I think there's only been one release, but I seem to see differences between 1985 and 1987. But finally, you get this figure. Now, this is not the only version of this figure. It will be released again inside the barge. Rather expensive way to get hold of it, but he will come with a drink, a small little plastic tumbler, and that is the exclusive piece and card inside. So it's a very exclusive Vintage Collection figure. I believe the numbering is exactly the same, so kind of OCD number peeps, you will be fine, but yeah, if you really want it, you gotta get the barge. Stay tuned, yakface.com and Darkside Toys will be giving one away. So check out for that coming up soon. So figures on the back, all of the ones which will be reviewed or are reviewed already, Infus Nest, Luke Skywalker, etc. Nothing in that text, I think, that will really keep you up all night and be too excited. Star Wars Vintage Collection logo and lots of different languages of don't stick it up your nose, blah, blah, blah. UPC should you need it. That's it. Nice card. Do like the picture. And they've done a really good job of the image. Just it looks really nice. Looks very chill. There's his little glass there. You can just about see it in that. It's very dark, but kind of translucent green. And he's looking very chilled, hanging out there in Jabba's barge, which you can maybe own. So the stand is my own again. Link to that in the description below. But I really like this. I love his wet nose. Like a big dog, he looks superb. Very, very cool indeed. I do like this. Nice figure, soft goods and mix of... kind of intended to be fabrics going on, so it's kind of cool. This is very Emperor Snoke costume or leftovers. I don't know, it looks a little like that. But it's still nice to have the soft goods, and there's not much going on underneath. Pretty simple kind of jumpsuit on him, or suit, with this furry piece in the middle, and little kind of pouches to the side. No other real major details on the figure, and his boots are relatively simple too. Really not a lot going on. Now, I don't think we've seen this pike before. I think this one is new. It looks slightly different to the others that we've had. But beautifully washed, I have to say. They've added a lovely kind of gold, coppery colour wash over the brown, browny kind of grey plastic, which gives it a really nice metallic and old vibe and feel. I like that a lot. Amazing with that little bit of paint, what a difference it does. I think they've really poured some love into this figure, so kudos to them. I think they've done a bang-up job of this figure. And again, that facial sculpt, the little wet nose, is just superb. It really works, I think. kind of unusual on the articulation department. He has a very weird neck, but it's kind of camel-like, I guess. But the way that you can see the articulation working there, if we can just focus, is it's a little tiny peg up inside there, and that allows you two pieces of articulation. So you can have his head all the way back like that, which is pretty superb overall, and then all the way back down. And then you've still got the neck as a separate piece of articulation too, so pretty damn good. Really quite nice. Same for the arms, regular kind of stuff. You can't really see it, but tucked in there, kind of basically a pretty good swivel and no real restrictions on it. There is no upper bicep, but there is a double, well, it looks like a double joint because it's really generous in the amount of articulation that it has. As you can see, that's pretty damn good. So even though it's a single piece, it really acts like a double joint because of the depth of the articulation there. Same for the hands. Whoops. Drop. Same for the hands. A really good articulation on those hands too. Just a little peg joint, but really, I mean, ridiculously movable, really, quite frankly. And of course, then swivel too. Down to waist articulation. It's not the top. It's just a wee seam where the cape goes under there. Waist articulation, so it's really an abbey waist articulation. There's a little bit of back and forth. You can see the joints up at the top on a kind of a hinge that you can see there. Upper thigh, swivel, single joint at the knees, no boot cut, and rocket ankles and peckles. He's pretty good. If you really wanted to round out your Jabba's Denzian, then this is the dude for you. He's very, very cool indeed. You're not going to see this guy in a hurry again, so don't muck around, pick it up. Bizarrely, it's still bizarrely, I'm seeing people who haven't got these yet on Facebook asking stores and things, are you getting these in? They're pretty cheap. They're pretty cheap, and the shipping's really cheap. Are you nuts? You do not want to miss out on these. I don't know why people wait for stuff. It's kind of... Anyway, never mind. If you've got them in your store, then that's wonderful. But loads of people have not, and they're barely just out. But, you know, hang in there, or just order them online. They're pretty cheap overall. Let us know what you think of Saelt-Marae, or Marae, or Yak Face, or whatever the hell we call them. Nice Return of the Jedi card. But again, we'll be back with more in just a second. So thanks again, and we'll see you for the next vid.